black and white, just like our coat of arms. Ulm on the Danube. 768 steps, 161 metres high. The Minster. The Tailor of Ulm, the Sparrow of Ulm, and Ulm's most famous scientist, Albert Einstein. He was born here in 1879, a city with a fascinating past. Ulm was an imperial city with flourishing trade and business. Barges carried goods and passengers down the Danube. The city was wealthy, and the citizens had a strong faith. In 1377, the foundation stone of a vast church was laid. No abbot, no bishop, not even a prince was involved. The Minster at Ulm is a civic church. The main tower was completed in 1890. It's the tallest in all Christendom. We look down on the White Civic Hall, designed by Richard Meyer. The people of Ulm are proud of their architectural heritage. The Minster Square, the City Hall, the new city centre. Lesson 1. This city is full of contradictions. That's what makes it so interesting. Lesson 2. The people here play an important role. But more about that later. The citizens of Ulm can be a bit rough-mannered with each other, but cordial to visitors. Well, that's better than the other way round. They enjoy the simple pleasures of life and are fond of understatement. But don't get us wrong, Ulm has been home to art and culture ever since the Ice Age. The famous Lion Man was carved in the nearby Lorna Valley some 35,000 years ago. Rather later came Cyrline and Mulcher, Klee, Macquet and Picasso, and a toboggan with fat and felt by Joseph Beuys, of course. Contrasts and contradictions, as we said. There's been a theatre here since 1640. Nowadays, we also have opera and ballet. This is how an Art Nouveau swimming pool sounds when converted into a concert hall. You're listening to one of the winners of the German choral competition, the Ulmer Spatzen Youth Choir. But that's not all we can do. Ulm's Youth Wind Philharmonic is Germany's best wind orchestra for young players. Yes, there's more to life than just football. Lesson 3. Culture has a long tradition in Ulm. Lesson 4. Our youngsters are very important to us. 10 grammar schools, an international school, technical college and university, science city. Enough to be going on with? And doesn't it all cost a lot to run? Of course, but then we earn money too. ₹120,000 inhabitants, roughly 81,000 jobs. That's good for the economy. We're at home in the markets of the world. That's a fact. Commercial vehicles are one of our core competencies. Pharmaceuticals and biotechnology are also well developed in and around Ulm. Everyone's heard of coffee to go, but what about car to go? Innovative car sharing, thanks to intelligent software. Developed and successfully tested in Ulm. Just like modern industrial design. the spirit of the legendary Ulm Design College lives on. Good ideas have a long-term effect here. Young and successful, Ulm's Science City. It provides most of the jobs in the region. Clinics, research institutes, the science park, and startups clustered around the university. Others may be larger, but we possess the excellence. An optimistic outlook. We have attractive jobs for everyone who's looking for more than one perspective on life. And if you work hard, you've earned a break. In Ulm, the distances are short, so you get to your leisure activities faster. After all, money's not everything. Talking of quality of life, what's your choice? There's room for all, even if it is a bit crowded at the Einstein Marathon, where over 5,000 take part. Need to cool down now? Then what about the Narbada? Your boat doesn't even have to float, just sink gracefully. Narbada means bathing down the river, and that's what the people of Ulm do on their special holiday Monday. Every year since 1397, the mayor has repeated the city's oath.
Reichen und Armen, ein gemeiner Mann zu sein, in gleichen gemeinsamen redlichen Dingen, ohne allen Vorbehalt.
Public spiritedness is important to us, but that would take up a whole film of its own. Would you like an encore? Well, why not? We can offer you sun and plenty of water, rivers and lakes, Lake Constance, and alpine snow too. There's skiing and tobogganing in the nearby Allgäu region and across the border in Austria and Switzerland. Of course, if you prefer to work overtime, we won't stop you. To summarize, Ulm occupies a central position in southern Germany, with motorways leading north, south, east and west, intercity trains, and four airports within reach. Top rankings are not the only things in favor of this city on the Danube, a city on a human scale. Enough of words and pictures. Let deeds commence. It's black and white. Ulm.